Have you ever wondered what games you should keep or you should lose? Find out here at Purdue's.
Escape Zombie City is a meshing of two things I really like. I like zombie things, and I like Escape the board game. And when you put these two things together, you got a game that I enjoyed quite a bit. I do like the aspect of the zombie horde coming out. You got to get on the van, you got to run, you got to have certain supplies, and it gave you kind of a mission, if you will, of what you're trying to do. All of this is being done in real time. If you ever played the board game Escape, which kind of takes the Indiana Jones IP or theme, if you will, to it, and puts it in you into a temple, and you're trying to get ruins and get out, this takes that pretty much the same game with a little bit of a variant, and put you into a zombie mix, and there's zombies coming at you, and you gotta run, you gotta fight them, and you gotta move around, you gotta cast the characters that you're going through, and I like it quite a bit. Now, some people are gonna be turned off by the real time. That's this game, and it really works fine. All you're doing is rolling dice as fast as you can, hoping to get certain combinations in order to progress in the game. Some games are gonna do better because you roll better. Sometimes you're gonna do worse because you don't roll as well. It's this frantic mess of what's going on, and I like it. I really do. And this is not the kind of game that I normally would find appealing. People ask me all the time, why do you review games you don't like? Why do you do this auction game you don't like? And you don't like auction games. Because every once in a while, I find a gem I do like. And if your tastes match up with me, this would be something. If you don't like real-time games, this might be one to check out. This is a pretty fun game. You're working cooperatively. You're trying to bust down the zombie stuff. There's a little gamer stuff in there about needing certain supplies and getting the van and getting out. And I think it tells a really cool story. I've had fun with the family with this. I had fun with cooperatively with friends. And I've even tried it out solo before and had a pretty darn good time. So this is one that I would say I recommend. If you like Escape, I don't know that you need both. But I think that this has a different theme to it. It's a little bit of a variant, but if you really like Escape and you don't want to just get more and more expansions, then invest in this and have a little fun with a different theme attached to it. For us, absolute keeper, and I'm keeping this and Escape. Here's Escape Zombie City from Queen Games. Nice big box. If you ever played Escape, which has had the same game, just different theme, you can see the zombies on it, so you kind of know what you're in for here. Got some rule books, which we'll take a look at in a few minutes. So here's what you're going to get. You're going to get a little tile for your van. You're going to get dice. Each person will get a little meeple. Each of the dice are custom with different sides on it. There's enough here for four players. This will be the items that you get. The cardboard is really nice. This will be the little van you'll be driving in to get around. It's a big chunk of wood. The cards you're going to get are fine. I don't like the icons on this. Like, this means add a zombie, move a green one. I'm not crazy about that. You're going to have, the zombies will be in here. They're going to be standees. And they'll have different colors. I'll tell you what's needed on them. The artwork is okay. And then you're going to have your tiles that will be here. You're going to have A's and B's and starter ones. Here's the soundtrack. It's a CD. I use YouTube for that. It is what it is. You'll see the icons in order to find it on the back. And then you have the little locations here. You have the skulls. You can see where you're coming through. The icons need to move on it. And this is like a store where you get an item over here. It's very easy to see. Very colorful. Very nice tiles. Very thick. Queen gives you good components. Everything in the box is excellent. So here's the rule book. Picture the components here. You can see everything you have in the game. Introduction to goal. Setup over here. This is all setup that you'll have. And a little bit over here will explain the sections and how the dice work. Very easy. Once you get this, really, not a whole lot to it, and how the zombies kind of work, and then sequence play. This is exactly how Explore the City and Escape by Van. It'll break that down. So you play all the Escape by City. And I kind of did this, and then when we got through this part of it, I just paused the time, explained how to do this, and then we played it. I found that to be very easy. A little bit about the soundtrack here. There are cues you have to listen to. And then after the first two countdowns, kind of what you do here. So you need to know this and how to win the game. This will show you different scenarios, how to play it, how to make the game a little bit harder for yourself, and some of the bite cards that will come out with an explanation. I found the rule book to be very good. Queen makes some of the best rule books, if not the best rule books in the business, and this does not disappoint at all. So this is kind of how you set up the game. You have your starting tiles here. You'll shuffle up the A tiles and the B tiles, shuffle the A's together, shuffle the B's together, put A's on top of B's. And you'll put your little marker here to signify where you're staying. So let me show you how this setup is here. So if three zombies ever reach the church, whenever a zombie reaches the church, it comes up here. If there's ever three, you will lose the game. That's kind of how it works. As you gain items during the game, you'll go out and get items and you'll come back to the church. You will store them here.
And what they're going to let you do, you see here, based on number of players, so two players, you got to have five of these. And once you fill this up, then you have completed the first half of the game. Then everybody will jump in the van, and you'll try to leave in the van. And what you got to do is get to the exit tile. As you go through the city, you get the exit tile will be out. If you're able to get the van to the exit tile, then you will have won the game. So that's how you lose the game. That's how you win the game. What you're going to do is you're going to have a timer going, which will be the soundtrack. And on your turn, you're going to roll your dice as quickly as possible. I'll start out here. If you roll a frantic die, this black symbol here, then you will set this aside and you cannot roll it. Now I'm only rolling four dice. Unless you roll the caution die, which is the yellow one, then that allows you to bring two of these frantic dice back and you can re-roll them. Otherwise, what you're trying to do is very simple. You're trying to move these different locations. If you look here on the tile, it'll have two icons, a green runner and a blue fist. If I roll a green and a blue, I can use that to move to the next location. Now, once I use these dice, I must re-roll them. These dice I have not, so maybe I want to keep this green die, and I will roll the rest of the die. I got a frantic. I would set that aside. Once again, I'm rolling this as quickly as possible. Got another frantic, but I rolled a caution, so I can take two frantics back. But I rolled a green, and I had one saved, which would allow me to take a tile from the top of the deck. If you look on the back of the decks, it shows two of these. I can then set this out. I need to have the skulls facing where they're coming towards the center of the board. And then I would put an icon out here. So if these were not here, I would take one of these, put it on this location. And once again, I used these two greens, so I need to re-roll all my dice. So let's say I rolled a green and a blue. So when a new tile comes out, I should say that. So let me add a little wrinkle to the game. So when the game starts, you're going to have a number of these zombie cards that will be out. They will be placed right there in the graveyard. When I put the new tile out, I will flip this over, the top card, and do what it says. If it has this symbol on it, I will simply reach into the bag, pull out a zombie, and put it on this location. Now, some of these, like this one, you don't add one, you just move it. And when you move it on the space of the way the skull is going. So he would move down here to this location. Okay? So that's kind of how that works. If you want to defeat one of these, the zombie on it, and the red ones are the hardest, yellow are the medium, and green is the easiest, it'll tell you, I need five fists in order to beat this guy. So I'm probably going to have a hard time doing it on my own because I only have five die. So another player can go there and help me use their die. That's the only really time you can share die is when you're fighting a zombie. So if I were able to get the five fists, I would defeat this guy and he would go back into the bag. Now what's important about this location is this is how you get items. And if you look here on it, it will say I need three bats in order to take this. So if I were to roll the three bats on my dice and I rolled those and added this in, then I could take this. Now I can only hold one item at a time. And I would try to run back. So once again, to get back here, I need the green and the blue. And then to get back to the church, I need double green. Once I'm back in the church, I can deliver the item. And then I'm 1/5 of the way in a two-player game to winning the game. Here's into a three, an additional one for a four-player game. So once I have all the items here, and we have collected those, then I will come out in the van. And once again, the van has to get to the exit. Everybody's in the van, so you're technically working together. If you get into a location with the van with the zombies, you must plow through the zombies and defeat them. In the normal game, before the van comes out, you can just run from the zombies. Once the van is there, I have to defeat any zombies in my way or find an alternate route, right? Now, when you're moving with the van, it's important to note that it requires one additional green movement. So if it costs a green and a blue to move here, I would need to have two greens and a blue because one for the van. When I go in there. The nice thing about it is that everybody can fight together when you're in the van and everybody can roll their dice to try to get what you're needed. Now, with all of that said, there is a soundtrack attached to this and there'll be three times during the soundtrack that the music is going to stop. And this will be all well before the van comes out. If you hear that music stop, no matter what you're doing, you have to rush back to the church. If you don't rush back in time and the music starts up again or the signals are there for you, then you'll permanently lose one of your dice for the rest of the game, making it harder. So that's kind of how you play Escape Zombie City. It's very easy. You know, this deck of cards here will be putting more and more zombies out and making them move. Keeping in mind, if three ever get to the church, you will lose the game. You need to get the items here that you need in order to get into the van. Once you get into the van, you run for the exit. That is Escape Zombie City.
Who should buy this game? anybody who likes real-time games, right off the bat, you should get this. This is really fun. If you already have Escape, I don't know that you necessarily need this one unless you really like the zombie theme. Then you might want to get rid of Escape and get this one. I'm going to keep both, but I think I'm unique in that because I like the different aspects of it. If you don't like real-time, this is one I would say give a try to because it's not competitive. It's cooperative, so you're working together, so you don't have to really be better than everybody else, just kind of better than what's going on the board. Great family game, great game to play with kids, and adults can enjoy it also. Excellent game. I really like this one quite a bit. I like the series. I'd like to see more Escape stuff, to be honest. But Escape Zombie City is one I think flew under the radar for most people. Probably because most people liked the Indiana Jones kind of theme that's attached to Escape. They got their jollies with it. And they didn't really need this, but I do like it quite a bit. Keeper for me.